This is Apple M1 Mac running VirtualBox inside HostOS. In this video, let's take a quick look at the VirtualBox 7 beta running on Apple Silicon natively. Did anyone remember back in those days when Oracle had no intention of porting VirtualBox to Apple Silicon? But seems like they have changed their mindset and brought a VirtualBox for Apple Silicon. If you are the one who doesn't know what is a VirtualBox, let me explain to you in short. VirtualBox is an open source Type 2 hypervisor that runs on the HostOS and allows users to create a virtual machines. This way, the user can run another OS. So the operating system where the VirtualBox runs are called the HostOS, and the operating system that runs in the VM is called the GuestOS. Just remember, VirtualBox is a hypervisor, which means if the host CPU architecture is x86 or x64, it can virtualize the same type of OS seamlessly. But when it comes to Apple Silicon Mac, VirtualBox behaves the opposite, which is frustrating at this moment. It seems like VirtualBox is officially becoming an emulator that runs x86 guests on Apple Silicon host. Now let me show you what I meant to say in action. Go ahead and download the VirtualBox 7 Beta Arch 64 DMG for Apple Silicon Mac. You can try it on M1 or M2 Mac, both will work fine. Now once it's done downloading, go ahead and open the DMG and install the package. After the installation, launch the VirtualBox. Now you can see the VBox running natively on Apple Silicon Mac. Let's go ahead and create a virtual machine. I'm gonna choose new, then name the VM as Ubuntu, and you can see the Linux type is set to 32-bit automatically. And what's frustrating is that you cannot choose a 64-bit preset, which is super annoying. Anyway, let's keep moving further and import the ISO. In my case, I'm using the Ubuntu desktop ARM 64. For now, I'm gonna skip the unattended installation, then configure the CPU and memory for this virtual machine. That's it, now I'm done creating a VM. Now let's start the VM and see what will happen. Now as you can see, instantly the VM got crashed. This is the biggest problem with VirtualBox for Apple Silicon as of now. If you try to run any ARM-based OS, you end up seeing this message as unsupported CPU. Well, that's really sad. I guess Oracle needs to take inspiration from Utium or VMware, which are capable of virtualizing ARM OS on Apple Silicon Mac at native speeds. Anyway, like I said at the beginning, a VirtualBox for Apple Silicon is no longer called a hypervisor. It may be an emulator and can run only x86 OS. Now, with that inspiration, I downloaded Windows 10 x86 and created a virtual machine. When I ran a Windows 10 VM, this time it did not crash, but instead I can see the Windows 10 logo for a half second, and after 5 seconds, VirtualBox displayed this weird message. As of now, it seems like the VirtualBox cannot run any ARM or x64 OS on Apple Silicon. I admit that the VirtualBox is still in the early stage and it's not fully functional. But the Apple Silicon Macs do support virtualization, and there's even a separate framework in macOS explicitly designed to make the implementation of VMs very simple. I hope Oracle will fix everything in regards to VBox by the time it's ready for a stable release. As of now, if you want to create a virtual machine on M1 or M2 Mac to run Windows 11 or Ubuntu ARM Edition, then use a free software called Utium. Check out my other videos where I have shown installing Windows 11 and Ubuntu running on M1 Mac using Utium. And that's pretty much it. What do you guys think about it in the comment section down below? Thanks for watching my video. This has been KSK Ryle. I will see you in my next one.